الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد My dear respected brothers, elders, youngsters and sisters Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh Inshallah tonight we will be reciting the 23rd juz And we will be finishing Surah Yasin And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that Surah Yasin As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in hadith That whoever recites Surah Yasin in the beginning of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes their daily work easy for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept a lot of barakah in this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept a lot of power in this surah. It's the heart of the Quran, this surah subhanallah. And this was the desire of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that every follower of mine at least should know Surah Yasin memorized. And this was a similar desire in regards to Surah Mulk, Tabarak alladhi biyadihi al-Mulk, which will be coming in the 29th juz. So at least we should try our best, inshallah, to memorize this surah. Moving further ahead, in tonight's recitation, in towards the end of Surah Yasin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the punishment of the previous nations, what had happened to them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mankind understand the reality of resurrection when mankind will come back to life in the hereafter. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions about the stark warning of to all mankind that we are warned of the reality of this life and the life hereafter. That what is going to happen to us in this life as well as in the hereafter. It will not be one blast. It's not going to be like a blast. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala slowly is going to bring things in front of us for mankind to understand that look, understand. This is what is going to happen to you. Allah is going to give small warnings before something happens to this person. So now the juz also continues in Surah As-Saffat, a chapter characterized in very short verses. And powerful verses, very powerful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the angels. He's describing the angels in this juz. And also eavesdropping of jinnat, when they used to go and eavesdrop in the skies. And just to listen what the angels are talking about, what the angels are having conversation about. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's act of creation, that the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this creation and mankind. After this, in the following chapter, Surah As-Sad, we are again presented with stories of Anbiya alayhimus salatu wassalam providing lessons to mankind and consolation that what's going to happen to mankind and also consolation to Anbiya alayhimus salatu wassalam which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing. And the chapter carries Tawheed, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the revelation how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the final chapter of Zumur begins this juz by dealing exclusively with alone and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the only one to be worshipped. So what do we learn from tonight's recitation? Number one, Allah's sign in creation are described. Number two, man is warned against worshipping shaitan, that you should not worship shaitan. Number three, Allah is well able to create and resurrect. Allah gives life, Allah causes death, and Allah will bring back mankind to life. And number four, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's discussion between the people of paradise and the inhabitants of the fire of Jahannam. Then Allah, and also the fate of the pious people and the fate of transgressors. And the final, the story of Shaitan arrogantly refusing to prostrate to Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me and give us all the tawfiq to act upon it. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.